This video we will learn about analytical applications. What is analytical applications? The theory section I have already covered, and the link for that video is available in this video description. You can go through it to understand what is analytic applications. However, in this video I'll be going to cover about practically how to create analytical applications, what are different components available with the analytical applications. Basically, analytical applications are the same as stories, but there are some major differences between the stories and analytical applications. So analytical applications, here are some of the differences which tells about what is the difference between the stories and the analytical applications. So analytical applications are created by few experts, means there will be few experts or developers who can create analytical applications, but stories or applications would be consumed by many end users, unlike stories created. The other major difference is we can configure the behavior of the UI element, user interface elements, with the set of specific script API events, and then specify which action should take place when events are triggered. This is all about user interface. Some of the things which cannot be achievable with the story design, but we can do with the analytical applications. So there are some customized requirement from the business, and that can be satisfied only through the analytical application. That's why analytical applications came into picture. And this flexibility can give us create variety of an applications, from a simple static dashboard to highly customized applications with numerous options to browse and navigate data. These are some of the major differences between the stories and the analytical applications. We will see how to create. The first thing is analytical applications. We can create it from here. Create analytical applications. Once we create analytical applications, where we can see what we can do and what are the different things which are available here. Similar to stories, we do have chart tables, and we can insert chart here. Whatever the charts we are having, that we can create based on these applications. Like, we can create different charts similar to the stories. However, there are some other things which are extra available here. We can say, you can see this panel, tab strip, text input field. These are the many things which is like drop down, checkbox, grouping, and these are some of the components which are available. It's called as widgets, and these widgets will be available for different requirements. And you can say GeoMap is also available, clock, RSS reader, web page, then BPC, planning sequence. R visualization is again a powerful. I'll be covering separate videos on R as well. So these are some of the things. On the left side, you can see canvas, chart, and then pop-ups. There are some script variables, script objects, bookmark set, export to PDF. So there are so many things which we can have it, and we can create the analytical application as per our needs. So the only thing is about events and triggers and the scripting. So scripting is also one thing which we should be able to understand. Whenever we say scripting, every component will have, we can write script based on this, like on select or on result change, where we can write some scripting. So this scripting is nothing but a JavaScript language. So JavaScript is scripting language which is very popular, and it is number one language, we can say, for the web development, and that is why it is being used as a common term here. I'll be going to take a separate video on JavaScript as well, just to give an overview of the JavaScript. So that would be helpful. There are some other online resources as well available for JavaScript. If you can learn from there as well, it would be helpful. The other thing is about here. We have some chart scaling, conditional formatting. There are options, various options available. We will be taking this separately in a separate video, one by one, what all these components are there, like pop-ups. We can have pop-ups. I'll be taking a separate video on the pop-ups, how it can be useful to display different pop-up messages when we create an applications. And we can canvas is one thing where we can see there are a device in which device we wanted to see. If you wanted to see in a laptop, then we can see, or if you wanted to show this in iPad, then it will come in this way, or just iPhone. So based on the size of the phone, we can get this option available here while the designing of the application. So I think, means from my perspective, this is a very powerful tool. And if you know the scripting, and if you know the components, how would they interact with each other, and then we can build very powerful analytical applications. From this, there are various things which we can do, and whatever the customized requirement comes from the business, it will be helpful to create this such powerful applications based on this various components available. I'll be taking one by one example for each of these components, so that it will be helpful. So that's it from this video. I hope you have understood this. If you have any questions, then please put it in comment section. If you have some specific requirement where scripting can be useful, or you want to understand any specific points related to scripting or any other parts in the analytical application, please do let me know in comment section. I'll be happy to answer it. Thank you for watching.